So okay, in the previous video we have seen the basic command injection. So we have seen putting semicolon and sending the command to execute the command. So generally there may be filters to block some certain words from the request. So what you can do is you can bypass them using like this. So if you type, if you put the quotations to the command, it will execute as it is. If you can even put quotations to some letters in the command, so it will execute as it is. Who am I? So it will execute the command. So generally the blacklisting filters contain like who am I. So you can bypass them with the quotations, etc. So you can also put like first I will show you echo dollar at the rate. So it is a null string. So you can put this who dollar at the rate am I. So it will still execute the who am I. So upon rendering, this will be converted into the null byte. It's like nothing, empty, and who am I gets executed. So you can also try this. So these are some ways to filter the, so to bypass those filters. And the next thing is some predefined value in the Linux system. So if you type IFS, this is the internal field separator. So by default the IFS value is space. Sometimes in Linux systems, in some Linux systems, you will get the tab space as the IFS value. So that's why what you can do is, if you say ls minus la, you will get this output, right? So if you, you can also replace the white space with the $ifs minus la, so you can get the same still output. So sometimes the white spaces can also be blacklisted because this is the number right store ID, and no one wants to put the white space after it. So that's why it can also be a blacklisting character. And another thing is NV, environment variables. So here you will have so much of information. So you have different symbols like pipe and slash dot, etc. So the usefulness of this is you can say echo dollar path. So this is normal actual path variable. So you can slice the output from certain characters. If you want to only first 5 characters, you can say from 0 to 5. Okay, so how to do that is put the colon 0 to 5. Okay, it's 5. So you get the first 5 characters. So instead of first 5, I want only the forward slash. Okay, so what I can say is, I can say 1. Now you can see you got the forward slash. So if the forward slash has been a blacklisting character, so you can bypass them with this. Here how to get the value, you can first send the nv command to the as a request, so you can get the all the environment variables. So these variables might be different from your Linux system, because on the server system there will be some web programming languages, and that programming language can install some environment variables, so you can get much more advantage of it. So here you can see forward slash and hyphen, so you can also have the hyphen. If you want to execute ls minus la, so you can grab this one. So you can also have other characters like colon, so you can see the colon here. Also in the path variable you have the colon, so it's very good thing. So if the environment nv command is blocked, you can just say nv. So you can put the quotations and type the nv. Also if you want to bypass the space character, you can put the curly braces and you can send them as arguments. So like ls minus la. So this comma, so these two values will be separated by space and executed as a single command. So in our case it's executing the shell script. I think we don't get error if the backend is executing like OS commands. Okay, so we it says not found because of the shell script. I don't know the error is, but it will work on most of the systems. So ls ifs minus ls. So dollar ifs turns out to be white space, and you can get the ls minus ls. So let's also first let's try some of the environment variables, slicing the content from them. Okay, so path variable contains forward slash. So if I want to view ls home Peter, so we have the Peter user. You can see here pwd, so home Peter. You can also use dollar pwd, so ls dollar ifs for the space and dollar pwd. So if the pwd is in the environment variable, so send this, so you can see the normal ls. If you want to extract the forward slash, what we can do is, so we can say l, even the ls command is blocked, you can bypass that with the single quote ls, and then the space if you want to put ifs. So we will do this one. So what you can do is, you can also copy this entire content, entire value. You can say test is equals to this one. So t is equals to this one. So if I say echo dollar t, you get this value. So echo dollar, if you want the slice, you can put the curly brace t colon. So you want the hyphen character, right? 1, 2. So this is the 11th character, so I can just say 10 to 11. Okay, it's 11 to 12. I think this is taking as a single value. So let's see if we have some another hyphen. So we have in the log name echo dollar log name, I'm sorry, I thought in Python slicing. So from 10 you can say 1, so you got the hyphen. So I thought in the Python slicing, sorry for that. So from 10th character onwards, how many bytes you want? I want only 1 byte, so that's why you got the hyphen. So what you can do is, let's get the environment variables again. Now we need to say dollar sudo command 10:1, so that is the hyphen, I think. Yes, that is the hyphen. So we have ls space minus, we can say la, so this should do it. We should get the ls minus la output. Okay, we get the bare substitution, so you can ignore that one. So for if you are trying on some vulnerable website, you get the code execution. So don't worry about that. In our case, it's not getting this. So you can use any of this, and it's limited up to your creativity. Now I want to show you something. So echo who am I. So sometimes you can do the reverse command. So if you reverse the who am I, you'll get this output, right? So copy this, so what I want to do is I can execute this one. Okay, this should work. I don't know why it's not working. So basically you can use the reverse command. Okay, so using the pipe you can do this arrow. So if the who am I has been blocked even with the quotes, so what you can do is you can reverse that command and you can execute like this. So dollar, if you put a normal brackets, the content in that will get executed as a command. So echo space slash rev. So this pipe will all, you can also take that from the environment variables. So echo instead of space, I can say dollar ifs. So we got the username. So you can also do the base64 encoding. Echo who am I base64. So this is the value. This triple less than should work. I don't know why it's not working. Okay, so you can also try this. Simply copy this and paste it in here. After pasting, you can modify this one. So you can put the plus or IFS. So you can also remove this hyphen pipe. So still we got the code execution. Sorry, command execution. So that's how you bypass the blacklisting filters. So you can also Google this for command injection bypass GitHub. So you can go here and you can create a list of all the payloads and you can try that. So I always recommend you to get the result of passwd file, which is readable by everyone. And then you can filter the responses according to it. Also, you can get the payloads according to it. So you can see these are all the payloads you can test against the system.